The Shadow Minister for Finance, Mwanga Chivombi, who acted as the leader of opposition, raised a matter of national concern, condemning the acts of security agencies that sieged no party offices yesterday, arresting people who had gathered to pray for the souls of those who were allegedly killed in their political struggle.
We have always chosen a path of constitutionalism and the rule of law. When we had challenges with the Police Act, Section 32, Subsection E, and remember, you and me by that time were in popular resistance. We felt a level of discomfort. We went to the Constitutional Court, and the Constitutional Court overturned that provision as unconstitutional, giving powers of police to prohibit. Right, Honorable Speaker, the government came here and made a Public Order Management Act, trying to restate to police the powers that they enjoyed in the other Political Organizations Act. Still, me and a group of other civil society went to the Constitutional Court and overturned that provision. As we speak now, all that the police can quote is any just resolution they make without any recourse to any provision of the law.
Mwanga Chivombi challenged government to explain the violation of rights of opposition political actors by stopping them from holding assemblies, despite the Constitutional Court's decision to nullify sections of the Public Order Management Act, which requires police to approve political gatherings.
Honorable Speaker, it becomes difficult for me to sit here as an acting law and lead this side into this house without a very clear explanation from the other side, from the minister concerned, about what is taking place, because they are acting outside the law. And this house is about respecting the law. So until we receive that explanation, I'll be very hesitant to sit with honorable colleagues on this side and be in this house with the decorum that it is required. The police has no legal justification to stop any political party or any person from conducting business the way they want. This parliament, it's about 2 months ago. So even this parliament has made a pronouncement on that matter.
Despite pleadings from the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, the opposition demanded for unconditional release of all political prisoners, backed by a statement from the Minister of Internal Affairs, or less the walkout, which they finally did.
I have received a few issues from the leader of opposition. For example, I was informed, Honorable Chivombi, you're coming in. Okay? And usually my question is, are there issues we need to consult over? It's consulting. Consulting does not stop you from continuing and doing what you want. So, Honorable, me, I would urge that you've raised your case. We give the minister time. He brings a statement explaining, and then would be able to handle the matter.
Right, Honorable Speaker. The issues I'm raising are pertinent and they've been in the knowledge of everyone in this country. Either we receive a statement from the minister now, or I lead my troops outside this chamber.
Thank you.
That is our start.
Can move and we have.
However, over 10 opposition legislators remained behind for the rest of the session, including the Democratic Party Whip, Peter Okot, and UPC Party Whip, Santa Okot. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.